Everyone. So in our previous video, we have understood or understand about momentum of any object. We understand the physical quantity momentum, which is denoted by letter small p, and the definition of momentum was it is the product of mass and the velocity of any object which is in motion or in rest. Now you know that if any object is at rest having any mass, the momentum of that object will be m into v. If it is in rest, the velocity will become zero, therefore momentum will become zero. Okay. Again, you have understand that the momentum is a vector quantity, which means that momentum have both direction as well as magnitude. Further, what will be the direction of momentum? The direction of momentum will be determined by the direction of velocity of the object. The direction of velocity will give you the direction of momentum. Okay. Again, the SI unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second. We have already discussed it about, and further we have done some numerical on it. Now, in this class, we are going to understand about second law of motion. And we have to understand that how second law of motion is related to momentum of any object. Okay, class? Now, you can see the second law of motion on your screen. The second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum of an object is proportional to the applied unbalanced force in the direction of force. Now, in order to understand this statement, we have to understand that what the second law exactly says. Now, if you remember the first law of motion, the first law of motion states that any object will remain in rest position or in motion position until or unless any external force is applied on it. Remember, beta, आपको पता है first law of motion simply ये कहता था, कोई भी object अगर वो rest में है तो rest में रहेगा, motion में है तो motion में रहेगा, until और unless कोई भी external force आप उस पर apply नहीं करते हो.